Interactive of requirement. So what is inter and what is intra? The main difference between inter and intra.
It is related to billing. One is without billing and one is with billing.
Okay. And
inter.
Intra means it's like within the company code.
Without billing.
Within the company code. You have two plans. And you are transferring between those two plans. The company code is same. And in that company code, we have two plans. Okay. You are transferring the stock between the two plans within the company code, same company code. So at that time, there will not be no billing. Okay. So for this, we'll call it intra-STO. And next one is inter-STO. What is inter-STO? In your client, you will be having many company codes. In that, there will be many plans. Suppose if you have company code like 2200 and 1200 and under 2200 you have planned 1000, under 1200 you have planned 2000. So if you want to transfer the stock between these two plans, 1000 planned and 2000 planned, see here the company code is different. For 1000 plan, the company code is 2200, and for 2000 plan, the company code is 1200. Now, if you want to transfer the stock between these two plans, then there should be billing will happen because it's a two different company codes. Okay, because the profit loss accounts will be based on the company codes. So, if you are transferring between the two company codes, so there should be billing. Okay, and inter or intra, everything we'll call it as for intra and intra STO.
As in,
you say MMSD integration cycle.
Hello?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, you say MMSD integration cycle. So, what and all are MMSD integrations we'll do in SAP as a SAP consultant? For which and all concepts you will you will involve with the SC consultant? You know, we have inter STO, we have intra and third party. For these three things we used to sit with the SC consultant, and whenever you got a request, you used to sit with the SC consultant and used to resolve or used to create the new data. Okay. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Now it's
okay. So let's think, okay, we have two company codes. So here is the company code 1 and company code 2. The company code 1000 and company code 2200. Under this company code, we have plans 1000. 1200, 1300, 1400. Under this 2200 company code, we have plans like 1600, 1800, 2300, and 2200 is a planned.
Okay.
Now let's think. Okay, you are transferring one material. Even I have taken the material also from the previous PO. Material M02. It's like some type of chemical. M02 is some type of chemical formula. You are transferring the M02 material from 1200 plant to 2200 plant. Let's think. You are transferring stock from 1200. Plant 2200. So if you're transferring this plant to plant and two different company codes, we need to create a PO, and here PO It's like we need a vendor here. Okay, it's a two different company codes, right? So if you are doing billing, then we should involve the vendor also here.
Okay.
Okay. So we have PO material M02 and vendor. So vendor, we should do some configuration here. I will tell you what configuration we need to do. Let's make a note of the vendor number, 10,000.
Okay.
And we need to have some, it's not required. This is not required. So let's think, we are transferring the stock from the 1200 plan to 2200 plan. It's the two different company codes we are transferring goods.
Okay.
Okay. And here, once you create a PO, and what you'll do once you create a PO, you'll send it to the supplying plant. I will tell you practically before that I explain you theoretically so that it will be good to move further. So once this, what you will do, once this plant will create a, so this plant have a requirement to for the production of material M02. So this plant, what they will do, they will create PO with respect to one vendor and they'll send it to this plant. What this plant will do? This plant will do OBD. What is OBD? Outbound delivery. VL 10D. And once they do OBD, then even the same HD department, they will do PGI. What is PGI? Post to goods issue. VL 02N. So once this is done, simultaneously they used to send the goods to the receiving plant. What receiving plant they used to do? They used to do MIGO. And here the billing will happen. And after that, the MIGO will happen. Billing will be done by the SD consultant.
Okay.
That's it. So for this, what we require now? Material we require. I'll show you the material, what null configuration they have done in material. And I will try to create one material also by copying the reference from the M02 material.
Okay.
I will open my SAP laptop 1 minute. These things you need to understand practically because you need to work with the many people here.
Okay.
To sit with them and you used to resolve the issues.
Okay.
For material master, what are required? What all views are required for material in material master if you are creating for an inter and inter STO? So using that material for inter and intra STO, I told you few views are required along with the normal views. Shivangi, are you there?
Yeah, I'm there.
Okay. I told you few views are required for inter and intra STO for every material. If you are doing intra and intra STO, we need some views. Go to MM01. I told you to take material M-02. Okay. M-02, we'll copy the material from M-02. So for material type, what you will use for material type if you are doing sales and all?
Finished.
Okay. Semi-finished or semi-finished? Okay. Let's take sales 1, sales 2, and sales 3. Okay, sales general by plan data. Okay, just execute. And this is the, what is the plan I told? 1200. And what is the sales organization? I am making a note from the previous PO. So, I will maintain those sales organizations. I'll show you the PO also, which PO I have taken. Go to ME2L keep the material m dash 02 and you will get some POs, and those POs I have taken.
Okay.
Okay, before call I have taken. Okay. So what is the sales organization I have taken means 22 00, and distribution channel I have taken 10. Okay. Just execute. Just in the show text, intra STO and maintain basic intra measure and material go. Okay, these things are important. And sales organization one. Here, what you'll update? Division on tax.
Okay,
here they didn't maintain tax code, but we need to maintain tax code. Okay, and division, everything will be given by the SG team. And this is the master data for SG team. They have to prepare this master data. You know, you need to worry of these things. And sales organization two, you need to maintain item category group. You need to maintain item category group. Maintain as bands. General item category, leave it. Sales by general plant. Maintain transport group and loading group. Loading group maintain 003 0003. Okay, that's it. And maintain purchasing group. Okay, here this is our data. Purchasing tab is our data. Okay, before we did sales data, that is for sales. Okay, and maintain the valuation class. And maintain the price and save the material. And what is the material we created? 350 541. And next we require vendor. Okay, now we will go to action SK. We will create a new vendor.
Okay.
Before that, we need to change one vendor.
Ram, I'm coming. Just give me 1 minute, please.
Yeah, okay. SAP. It is enter. Okay. Just enter it. Customer number not required. It's not required. This is the company code data where we'll fill by the FI consultant, FI team. Okay.
Okay.
Accounting information and all. And this is the information you used to fill purchasing data. They used to ask you what and all tabs you can see in purchasing data. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And you used to go to extras here. So if you are doing any inter STO, you need to go to extras. And you need to maintain as add purchasing data. Here maintain supplying plan. What is supplying plan here?
1200.
Okay. Just we maintain save here. It means that if you, whenever you mention this vendor, automatically it will like supplying plan as 1200. Got it?
Okay.
Whenever you are created with any PO with this vendor, you will like supplying plan as 1200. The vendor number is 1002833. And we forgot one more thing. Material we need to extend it to receiving brand. Two one two eight is the material number. Maintenance age organization. Is that what the plan? 2200.
00.
Receiving plan we are extending. Next code 07. Item category group for normal loading group 003. Adjusting group evaluation plan. Standard price. Okay. So 2128 we extended for the plant, 1200 and 1200 and 2200. Now we have vendor also, we have plants, we have material, and now we need to maintain the configuration settings. Configuration, what you will go? Where you will go configuration? Now go to purchase order. Here, set up stock transport order. And if you see here, set up define shipping data for plants.
Okay.
Here what you will select? Maintain 2200. And I maintained here, see.
Okay.
This I taken from the previous PO. Before the class I have taken. But not sure I have didn't tested it's working or not. but I will test now. Okay.
Okay.
Take the receiving plant, maintain the customer code number plant. What is the customer code number we have? 22000. And sales organization, what we have? 22000. Distribution channel is 10. And division is 00. And language is French. This is French. This is F4.
Okay.
Okay. Just save it. So we maintain shipping data for receiving plant. Now we should maintain assign delivery type and checking role. I told you one difference for inter and intra. What delivery type? What is the delivery type for intra? Delivery type for intra is NL.
Okay.
And delivery type for inter is NLCC.
Oh, yeah.
And what is the document type for intra? What is the document type for inter? Intra. Like while creating PO, you need to select one document type in intra. What is the document type you need to select in intra? That is UB document type. Okay. UB document type will select for intra. And here you select NB document type. This is a normal PO. You are doing billing, right? You are doing billing and you are maintaining the vendor number also. So you need to create PO with NB document type, item category blank.
Okay.
Okay, here NB document type NLCC. I will NB document type. What is supplying plant here? 1200. And what is the delivery type? NLCC.
CC.
And what is the checking rule? 01. Checking rule, why? It's like you show, you'll show error like the stock is not lying in the plant.
Okay.
And here you see here, assign document type, one step procedure, under delivery tolerance. Here you need to assign the, what is the delivery type you are creating and what is the supplying plant, what is the receiving plant.
Okay.
Okay. Supplying plant is 1200. Receiving plant is 2200. And what is the type of order?
NB.
Okay. Just save it. So that will come automatically. If the customer number is wrong, it will show error like the customer number does not exist.
Okay.
Purchase organization is 2200. Purchasing group is 300. Just enter it.
Think so.
ME2M and ME2L also. ME2M is with respect to the materials. ME2L with respect to the vendor.
Okay.
You can see one PO here, which is catered for the InterStivo.
This is the previous one, right? That we created.
This is the previous one. Like I don't know. I have taken data from this one.
Okay.
Okay, wrong. So everything you should take from here, but few things okay. In the configuration it will not show, so there is the error scheme.
Okay,
so in real time also you need to get, you should get these errors and all. Okay, customer number does not exist, loading group, this and all, you should get all these errors. You need to send it to SD consultant. SD consultant will check all those SD settings and all. Once you check all those SD settings, we need to check the configuration settings for the shipping data for receiving plan, delivery type. We need to check whether everything is correct or not. Okay. Whether for the vendor number, the plant has been assigned or not. So everything we need to check. And after that, we need to analyze where is the error and all.
Okay.
Okay. And if you see here, the customer numbers, the shipping time came automatically with NLCC type. What is NLCC? InterStivo. InterStivo. Got it?
Yeah.